Good morning. My name is Dave. Welcome to my channel. I'm a long-haul truck driver in North America. So we're just going to pick up an empty trailer this week. Out to Western Ontario there, switch trailers, and down to Green Bay, Wisconsin. First of all, we've got to find this empty. So let's get it done. So that's me just left the shipper in Dryden, heading down to the border at Fort Frances International Falls. I know I've mentioned this a few times, but going down this road, this one here, the 502 now, in about 5 minutes I get absolutely no phone signal. And that's it for a couple of hours. So pretty remote. I say that every time I come down here. I know they're, sorry guys, but it is. It's shocking out here in the winter when you think what could happen. So, 12:15. We should be at the border for probably about 2:15, 2:30. And then we'll see how far we get tonight. Still got 982 kilometers to my delivery. So late morning tomorrow by the time I get there. And then we'll see what they've got for us. So that's it for now guys, I'll be back later. Thank you. this is us. Been past here a couple of times, a place called Propter, where the plane and the train and whatever else is up there. And you drop down, and this is Minnesota, so I'm across the border now. And you drop down the hill towards Duluth down here. But I'll be coming off before I get to Duluth to head across the other side of the lake there to Superior. So we're not making bad time today. Everything gone according to plan so far, so I'm hoping to get down to Auburn in Wisconsin tonight. Still a couple of hours from there yet. And I've got 2 hours 20 minutes driving left. So I'm hoping to make it there. Leave about 3.5-4 hours in the morning to make delivery then. Well, that's driving time. I'll have to stop for fuel in the morning. I could do. Yeah, I've got enough for tonight. So we'll get the fuel in the morning. So up ahead you can see the lake that we're going to be crossing. I'm not sure if this is actually classed as part of Lake Superior right here. But whether it's a river or not, I'm not sure, but it all runs into Lake Superior, which is just further over to the east there. Hence the name of the town, I would imagine. How good's that, eh? We've got to be home Wednesday this week, so this is just another short one again. Another dentist appointment, coming towards the end of them now. Two more appointments, one on Wednesday, one on Thursday, and one the Friday after. Well, 8 days later. So eventually coming to an end with the appointments, which is just as well before I go bankrupt. I don't know if you can see it over to the right there, but that's a bridge we're going to be going over in a second. Well, in a minute or two. Takes us right across the water there into Superior on the other side. Still quite a lot of ships sailing about on the Great Lakes and around here. Still a lot of stuff gets shifted. There's a second bridge which I can see, but I don't think the camera will pick it up. That's been closed for a while. No, well, the bridge hasn't been closed. It's been closed going southbound. So we're having to use this one just now, but if you cross on the other bridge, you actually see quite a lot of ships around there. There's some docks up there at Duluth. Well, both sides, Duluth and Superior, there's docks on both sides. You guys can stay with me till we get across this bridge into Wisconsin. park up tonight. I've had enough already. I did think about parking up in Superior. A couple of truck stops there that are half decent. So I did think about parking up there. But to give me a chance of getting home on Tuesday night, I need to do a bit more. If I stayed in Superior, I wouldn't be back till Wednesday morning. There's no big deal. I don't need to be back until Wednesday night, but I don't want to stay out an extra day if I don't have to, so do as much as we can tonight. Once we if we found out where the reload's from, then I could have made that decision, but we still don't know. So, like I say, we'll do as much tonight. And see where the reload's from tomorrow then, and then we can decide what we're doing. May well decide to have an easier day tomorrow. We'll see. They still shift out quite a bit of coal by ship around here. I don't know if they bring the coal into here or ship it out of here. That I don't know. But there's a big coal dock over to the left there. We actually we passed one over a little bit later as we're going up just on the outskirts of Superior, just leaving it just before where the truck stops are. We actually pass underneath a conveyor belt that leads down into the dock. But like I say, I don't know if they unload or load it here. So we are in Wisconsin now. Got a roundabout down here as well, which just confuses them all. I've even had somebody stop right on the roundabout to let me out, thinking they had to give way. So yeah, it gets a bit interesting. Roundabout. You've never seen anything like it, the way some of them perform on here. Certainly getting more common, no? The roundabouts are popping up everywhere. If only they knew how to signal on them. It'd help everyone. Right. So that's it, guys. If I come across anything interesting, I'll be back. But if not, we'll see you in the morning. Monday morning now, it's 9:30 and I'm just about 3 mile away from my delivery. So I've also got my reload. Same reload I'd done a couple of weeks ago out of Milwaukee, just a couple of hours south of my delivery here. And that's going straight back to Winnipeg. So we shouldn't have any trouble getting that on today. I'll then see where we end up tonight. We could be back home tomorrow night, but failing that, be first thing Wednesday morning. So a while since I've been at this delivery. Different one than 2 weeks ago in Green Bay. The one 2 weeks ago, they're really quick at unloading. This one isn't too bad, but they're a bit slower. But it has been a while since I've been here at this one. Good few months anyway. So we'll see how they get on when we arrive there. I'm just going to make the one video out of this whole trip, with it being such a short trip. So we're not going to end it here and then restart again from a reload. We'll just make the one video. I'm going down. Well, just down the road here, I'm going to be making a right-hand turn. If you had to turn left, you're on Lombardy Avenue. That's where the American football team, the Green Bay Packers Stadium, is just down there. Passed it many times. Big place. Huge place. By the way, we always came into this delivery. I'm thinking they built a lot of new roads and new junctions around here. I'm thinking that's probably still the quickest way of coming in. I don't see the point of coming in the way I did. But it's the way the sat-nav wanted me to come, so I thought I'd have a look at it because I'd never been on that new stretch of road. But yeah, I think it's still quicker coming in the other way. Don't change. Nice one. Now, if you turn left here, the Green Bay Packers Stadium's down there on the left. I might come back out that way. Then I'd be able to let you see it. Right. So delivery is almost straight ahead of me, right in front of me there. I'll have to make a right turn and then a left to get in the gate, but that's the place right in front of me. So we'll be back after the delivery. So that's the delivery done. It's 20 past 10. So 40 minutes since I last smoked yet. Been in. Made the delivery, swept the trailer out, just cleared those railway lines, and that's it. On my way for my reload, I'm going to stop on the way down there for a shower. And GPS wants me to turn left here. As I explained on the way in, I don't think it's the quickest way coming here. But I want you to see, I think it's called Lombard Fields or something like that, where the Green Bay Packers Stadium is. It's just down here on the left. I don't know if the camera can pick it up already, but it's down there where the big American flag's flying. right inside of the stadium. Yeah, I'll the camera is facing me. I'm going to turn it off just now. There we go. So that you can get a better view of the stadium as we pass. Huge place. When I get a chance after, I will have a look at the capacity of this place so that I can let you know. It's called Lambeau Field, or Lambeau. But that's it there on the left. I came past here one match day. It was about 3 or 4 hours before kickoff, and the whole place was still packed. About 3 or 4 hours before kickoff, they were out in the car park there having tailgate parties and barbecuing and everything. They certainly make a day of it. Right, well, I'll be back later. Cheers, guys. So I had a quick stop back there, just to use the facilities, and I had a look at the capacity of that stadium. Lambeau, whatever it is 81,441, so close to 81,500 capacity. Biggest venue in Wisconsin, and the fifth largest stadium in the United States. So yeah, I knew it was pretty big, that's all I knew. Be back later. Here we are in Milwaukee now. It's only 1:05. And I'm only 1.5 kilometers from my pickup. So we're going to be there in good time. I've got to do at least 3 hours after I've loaded to be able to get home. So I've got a bit of a workout where I need to be tonight. And well, it should be easy doable with the hours that I've got left. So it'll be nice to get home again tomorrow night already. And that'll be me till Friday. Definitely not made for big trucks around here. It's not bad, but it's the way that the others drive around you that's bad, not the roads. Like here, there's only one lane. I've had them undertake me. Just before I turned the camera on, I had one undertake me back there. Because there was no cars parked, so he thought it was okay. You need eyes in the back of your head. But anyway, where I'm loading is just over on the left. Real old place this is. Really tight loading docks as well. Two loading docks side by side, but I reckon if there's anybody on the one next to you, you're not going to be able to back in there. You're going to have to wait. So that's us here to load, and we'll be back later. And there's nobody else here. Happy days. Good morning. Tuesday morning, 22nd of August, I believe it is. It's only 6:30 in the morning. I started about half an hour ago. I'm almost around Minneapolis already. I got into Wisconsin last night and just stayed at the first rest area there in Wisconsin. In Minnesota, sorry, I got into Minnesota. So I had a really good day yesterday, about 1,055 kilometers or something it was, with an unload and a reload as well. So pretty good day at it. But what that means is I'll be back in, this load's going to Winnipeg, and I'll be back in Winnipeg for mid-afternoon. And home in time for tea. Spot on. Be back later, guys. So it's 25 past three and I've already crossed the border. I've already been into Winnipeg. I've already switched trailers. And this is me just coming through a little town called Blumenort, which is just about 5 miles north of Steinbach. So yeah, nearly done. Be on my way home soon enough. So I got a loaded trailer out of Steinbach, so I've just got to go back and drop this off, hand all the paperwork in, and then I can go home. I've only been gone 2 nights this week. I've only worked 3 days and I'm not leaving again till Friday, but I can't wait to get home. I don't know what's wrong with me this week. So yeah, get home. Wife's at work, so just me and the dogs when I get home. But that's it, guys. Thank you very much for joining me. It's been a pleasure. I do enjoy showing you around this this continent of North America. And as always, stay safe, take care, and I'll see you on the next one. Cheerio for now.